Bears are important. They are big and powerful animals. Learning about bears helps us understand nature. We can also learn how to protect them. Bears are fascinating to watch. They are very smart. They can use tools like sticks and rocks, and they are very good at finding food. Studying bears is important for conservation. By understanding their needs, we can protect their habitats. This helps keep bears safe for future generations. Let's explore the amazing world of bears together. We will learn about the different types, their homes, and their lives.
There are different types of bears around the world. Each type has special features. Brown bears are very large. They have brown fur and a hump on their back. Some brown bears live in forests, while others live in mountains. Black bears are smaller than brown bears. They have black fur, but some can be brown or even white. Black bears live in forests and eat a lot of berries and nuts. Polar bears are white and live in the Arctic. They have thick fur to keep them warm in the cold. Polar bears are excellent swimmers and hunt seals on the ice. These are just a few examples of the different types of bears. Each type is special and has adapted to its environment.
Bears live in many different habitats. They can be found in forests, mountains, and even icy landscapes. Brown bears often live in dense forests with lots of trees. They need plenty of space to roam and find food. Black bears also prefer forests. But they can adapt to living near humans. They are sometimes seen in backyards searching for food. Polar bears are found in the Arctic region, where it is very cold and icy. They have special adaptations like thick fur and blubber to survive in this harsh environment. Bears need our help to protect their homes. By conserving forests and reducing pollution, we can ensure that bears have safe places to live.
Section 4, bear food. Bears are omnivores, which means they eat both plants and animals. Their diet changes depending on the season and what food is available. Brown bears are powerful hunters and will eat fish, deer, and even smaller mammals. They also eat a lot of berries, roots, and insects. Black bears are more opportunistic eaters. They will eat whatever they can find, including berries, nuts, insects, and small animals. Polar bears primarily eat seals. They use their keen sense of smell to locate seal-breathing holes in the ice. Then they wait patiently for a seal to surface for air. Bears need a variety of food sources to survive. Protecting their habitats ensures that they have access to the food they need.
Section 5. Baby bears. Baby bears are called cubs. They are born blind and helpless. Mother bears are very protective of their cubs. Brown bear cubs usually stay with their mother for 2 years. During that time, they learn how to hunt, find food, and survive in the wild. Black bear cubs also stay with their mother for about 2 years. Mothers teach their cubs important skills, like how to climb trees to escape danger. Polar bear cubs stay with their mothers for even longer, about 2.5 years. Mothers teach their cubs how to hunt seals on the ice, which is essential for their survival. Baby bears are adorable and vulnerable. By protecting their mothers and their habitats, we give these cubs the best chance of survival.
Section 6, bears together. Bears are generally solitary animals, but they do interact with each other. Brown bears are known for their aggressive behavior, especially during mating season. Males will fight each other for the right to mate with females. Black bears are more tolerant of each other, especially when food is plentiful. However, they can become aggressive if they feel threatened. Polar bears are also solitary animals, except for mothers with cubs. During mating season, males will travel long distances to find a mate. Bears have complex social interactions. Understanding these interactions helps us appreciate their intelligence and adaptability.
Section 7, protecting bears. Bears are amazing animals that play an important role in their ecosystems. It is our responsibility to protect them. We can help bears by supporting conservation efforts. This includes protecting their habitats, reducing pollution, and educating others about the importance of bears. We should also be aware of our impact on bear populations. This means keeping a safe distance from bears in the wild and storing food properly to avoid attracting them to human areas. By learning about bears and working together, we can ensure that these magnificent creatures continue to thrive for generations to come. Their future is in our hands.